Let's see if we can explore that a bit more, because I can follow you very easily when you talk about the vagal nerve, the reptilian brain, and then how that might relate with the fight, flight, and freeze responses. But for others, they might not have an idea what the vagal nerve is, what its function is. So I think you'd be a good person to ask, where is the vagal nerve originating from, and what is its main function?
Yeah, that's a really interesting question. It originates from the brain stem, which is in the back of the neck, and it's known in medical terminology as the wanderer because it travels to all the different organs via the spinal cord. So it innervates the heart, the lungs, the pancreas, the gut, the other organs, and it is divided into two parts. There is a part that goes to the front of the face and neck, which controls your facial expression, your reaction, your body emotion, and that's generally reactive, and that will keep you engaged in the real world. But when that gets overloaded, the part that gets then activated is known as the dorsal vagal nerve, the part that is at the base of the spine that we've inherited from the reptile ancestors. And it requires very little sort of blood supply, and its job is to shut down the brain and to protect the internal organs. So by default, it puts you in a prone position where you're really waiting for the danger to pass, as it were, so that you can restore function. And all the organs at the surface would sort of shut down, so the blood supply would, you would feel cold in those experiences. And I often find when re helping these patients to recover from the trauma that they will experience that cold feeling,
And shivering and
that
shaking.
cold and shivering and shake feeling, because they're reactivating what the vagus nerve did. And it was studied very much in depth by Dr. Stephen Porges about 20 years ago with newborn children, where it was more prevalent to be activated. And the idea was that too much activation could be a bad thing because it could result in the child not surviving if it was overly dependent on this vagus nerve. So the ideal situation is that the vagus nerve is designed to slow down the heart, and that the two systems, the sympathetic system and the parasympathetic system, need to be in balance for us functioning adequately. But when the vagus nerve becomes overactivated in the most severe types of trauma, it can cause all the other systems to go out of balance.
Very interesting. And I would add to that that when we are in a sympathetic activation, that all the, as you said, the activation, the blood goes to the extremities to prepare yourself for fight and flight, and it shuts down the digestive system. Over time, when that continues, it depresses the immune system. And
It just made me think of, you know, the expression when your blood boils and you get really angry. It's like what you're saying, the blood going to the surface. And I often will find, and I'll say to the person, where do you feel the anger? And it might be in the fists or the arms or in the extremities
Yours very
or the
often.
jaws very often. So that's a good example of how the feeling state mirrors the physiological state.
Absolutely. I often use the analogy of a dog, that a dog biting its teeth and growling, to show you that you have to back off when you come in its space. It's a really a good example of a fight, flight expression, which is a sympathetic nervous response.